Unbridled one. I'm just a bit ahead from where I was in the last episode, just probably wasn't in my way closer to where we have to go, and yeah. Right. I think this is a joke, pal. What's that guy? Sounded pretty pissed. Got a fight one. Big hunking sword like this, you know. Have you got any daggers or guns? You know, normal weapons? Oh. You can't see the appeal of a Chinese broadsword. This is why you assessed them to serve you. Huh? You're making this about me. Awful cookie for a two-bit black market. Whole point of business is giving your clients what they want. Sounds like an earth deal. This ain't something we want to get involved with. I deal only with clients I expect. If you will improve that you will be my weapons, under command. Test. The hell you on about? Now. You and I will spot the film and the boss. I'm getting real tired of fear high and mighty. Fine. If you want a fight, I'll take you. See how you like your pressure scanner better when I'm using it on you. Indeed. This is a test of your proficiency in the world. Ha! I ain't gonna feel sorry when you lose an arm. What if I straight up end you?
Kono boke! Skushi arapuru ikimasu.
So we finally get to use weapons, do we? Heard those moves with that stick. That's the martial art I've ever seen before. He's got the other two sword looking like a damn chopstick. Son of a bitch! You're fine.
Oh?
Yeah, what do you expect? Give me a shit sword like this. That stuff you got's a way better weapon.
This is merely a piece of lumber. The sword you hold on the other side, hand, is a masterwork and painstakingly crafted.
What?
Oh. But apparently, you weren't fit to wield it. I would ask that you do not return to my shop.
Huh? To hell with your lamb shop. I hope it burns with you in it. Rumors say you were the dealer to be, so I went to the bother of tracking you down. For what, you fraud?
Shit. I used to be starting. I'm already attracted to someone while you are still doing.
Oh, hello there.
Goons.
Ah, Majima. Curious meeting you here.
Oh, it's you. Don't put me like that, Goons.
I was merely wandering about, in search of a place where the two of us could spar on the road.
That's so. Well, the riverside's occupied at the moment. A real nice to cut some rest on that.
His name is Feiho, a local arm stealer. Quite a master himself, too, so long as a weapon rests within his hands.
Uh-huh.
You know that guy?
Sayo.
I knew his father for ages. Back when he worked his cell. Checking in on him was half my reason for coming to Sokyo. As long as we are here, why don't I introduce you?
Hey,
do not ask for any favors. Oh, don't be so stubborn. This will be good for the bottom.
How do you feel?
Besides, time to sneak off as long as. It seems Feihu has been aware of your presence from the start.
What? Apology is coming, son, but I do not trust his name. He has some error to do about it.
Now don't go being so stubborn on me too. Delay no longer and put him to the test. I can tell you already, this human will most certainly pass.
Say what?
What the hell do I go to a test? I want no business with this guy's job. Come, come, Majima. I saw that look on your face as you were witness to the fight. A look of inspiration. And now your silence speaks volumes of the thing. That curiosity of yours is one of my keenest tools. It's one of the keenest tools in your armory.
Nothing fancy enough to call inspiration. Just a few dumb thoughts.
Yes. Well, if they were enough to match Fayeho's skin, it would be the stone, straight thoughts, and more akin to a full-blown revelation. Whether you give that revelation life or some of it out is your choice. Care to at least give it a try? Listen, I've had a long last day, and I'm tired as a dog. Let's make this quick. I assume you have no objections, Seiho.
You should recommend him so strongly.
Very good. It is settled. Now, what will it be? The man is an arms dealer. He can procure for you almost anything you might want.
No, I'm good with that beat up old bat.
Huh? Baseball bat? This should be quite an entertaining match. Steady now, begin!
Shift the item. Switch to slugger style. By mastering the strong defensive potential that the bat offers, when you guard using a weapon, you're less likely to be staggered by an attack. So at the this slugger style to defeat Fayeho and pass the test. Well, that was fast. I certainly did not expect you to use a bat so well. You are quite an interesting fellow.
Just remember using one back when I was running race on the competition. Thing I've improved since then, though. Surprised me too. I knew you could fight, but I did not think that a spur of the moment selection like that would get you far against Fayeho. Shows what I know. So, Fayeho, bat.
What do you think of my bat work? With flying colors, of course. You're precisely the sort of person my business exists to sell. The weapons shop, you know. That's nice of you to offer, but as you've seen, I ain't really interested in the conventional stuff. So much the better. I'm not a common dealer pounding off weapons I've salvaged. Well, that's cryptic. What do you mean? Are you free at the moment? My shop is fine. I wouldn't give you the chance to escort you there and explain exactly what it is for you. Oh.
Hi.
This is our shop, the Dragon and Tiger. At Warby, a Chinese restaurant operated by myself and my wife.
Yeah.
This is my wife and what?
New customer, yes. Many happy returns.
You said it wasn't your average weapon store. What exactly is it? Most of the products we sell here are meticulously hand-forged by me. Bespoke, assuming. Made to order, huh? So you ain't an arms trader, you're a smith, is what you're saying. Precisely. Now, if I may, I would like to explain how it is I go about making weapons. The Dragon and Tiger, you can enlist a host of agents to locate weapons here and other equipment. It can be hard to hand down the following three categories. Here recipes and notes. Put the agent's skill to use and gather the world's most famous weaponry and equipment at your fingertips.
send these agents around the door looking for real material and such. That is believable. Our goal in all this is to develop a robust network with arms dealers to the world over. But some agents' work takes them far from civilization. So basically, you got this guy searching for treasure out of the main ship. I'm all about that, actually. Indeed. The modern archaeological sites produce some of the most beautifully wrought and historically important weapons. The shop is always on the lookout for such things. Furthermore, customers whose contributions pass a certain level are given a special reward, private arms license. Yeah, so I'm guessing that means you were holding that one before that point. Naturally, that was only a test. You're one slippery. Speaking of which, I just remembered I ain't paid yet. I'm half starved already. You said this place is a Chinese spotlight, yeah? Can it be a special idea?
Oh yeah. You customer for that side of business too? You wait, I fix you a feast.
You to keep being. What is that? The happy couple in some kind of trouble? I cannot share the details now. But in time, their shop might grow the ire of a terrible fool. What's that supposed to mean? Nothing to worry yourself over just yet. I just only that you drop by when you think of it. Perhaps buy something, send them out on a search. That sort of thing. Yeah, alright. I'm headed into the wilderness to train. Don't go letting that itch of yours to keep. Abilities. I probably can't get very much here. Yeah, I can't get anything. Right here? No. Way more money for that. So now I have to go all the way back down there. Okay. What's that girl person she asked? I thought.
What?
Aikido, what's your map? Are you lost?
No, I'm not.
Oh, and what's just standing around for all by yourself?
No, please.
What's with this kid? He's doing it right. Not talking to strangers, but he's dangerous. Better as a man working. Listen. Why don't you hike Tyler back to your mom instead of laughing at her? This time, nobody's with us.
Okay.
Off with you then, get a piece of it. It looks like she has something to say. Still, she ain't lost. I'm not gonna make it home again. Just hope there's no problem at this rocking around. There's an exclamation mark where I can't really do much about it yet. Actually, I wonder if I can use. Hey, you run out of eggs again. You were supposed to be out shopping. Sorry. Weapons customers told me to complain.
Good.
You guys seem busy. Want me to come back later? Oh, Majima-san. How are you? I'm sorry that you had to say that.
Hello, Majima-san. Anyway, back to eggs.
Hey, who?
This place is at market next time.
Oh. Alright, I'll be back with him soon.
Oh. While you're there, you can look for equipment for Majima-san too.
What? But I've never done anything.
Want Feihu to do what? We told you about agents, like treasure hunters, go find equipment and parts. Feihu, go find good things for Majima-san, make lots of money.
Is this work really such good money? What do you do, Wex?
is what we do, my son.
Oh, like actual sorry, destination. Quest and obtainable items, very well. I guess that's the only place I can go. Hercules sporting boots. Select an agent. Only have one agent. Okay, so if I spend this money, it finishes faster. Only this helps so much.
Okay, search request done. This time, we choose agent and destination to search. Oh, and don't forget, you can pay a little extra fun. Extra funds motivate agents, get better things and also compete sooner.
A little tip to get them to work harder, eh?
Makes sense. Alright, good luck, Taiko.
Hi.
Thank you. I will do my best. I'll contact you and your payer when I return so you can come pick up what I find. Pempua, make sure to lock the other one I met. I'll be going now. We dispatched an agent. We have dispatched an agent to see how long the search will take. Press the start and highlight equipment in the pause menu. We cannot dispatch another agent until the first one returns. When enough time passes, you will receive a notification on the payer to return to the dragon attack. Cool. I guess I unlocked that now. Then I decided to check. I wonder if I get to more side stories? What am I going to do? What to do?
That's probably a bad place for whatever.
Get you! Excuse me. The thing is...
Want something from you. Let's hear it then.
Yes, I'm trying to say is...
Yes, whatever you're chewing, you can take it. Spit it out.
I have a favor to ask. Can you... Please be my boyfriend.
What? Say what?
Am I hearing you right? I said, please be my boyfriend. Please, pretty please.
What, just like that? Your boyfriend? I mean, like, you want to be a couple, go on dates. What the hell?
Yes, that's exactly it. That's what my boyfriend does. You will be my one and only.
Right. Okay, back in the bastard for 6. What the heck is with this little lady? You should not run out on me on the street. Money that I be her man. Really, your eye on this thing makes me understand them less and less. I gotta get it together. Can't let her know she got under my skin. I'll give her a strong answer. Don't make it. Sure, why not? Alright, I like your style, dear. I'll take that as a proposal of marriage, and I accept. Let's set up.
What? That was way too fast. I'll keep things at the boyfriend level. Thank you very much.
What's that supposed to mean? I was already picking out the wedding colors in my head. Darn it.
Oh, darn it. I left out a few details, haven't I? I should clarify, I guess. I need you to pretend to be my boyfriend, not actually to my boyfriend. Excuse me?
Hi.
Pretend? Yes, you see, my father is visiting from back home, and he's demanding to meet my boyfriend. For several years now, he's been haunting me to meet suitors he's arranged for me. He was getting so persistent that I finally got fed up. I told him I already have a boyfriend, so back off. I also told you my boyfriend is staying worse than I died. It's a good point that Dylan has a little side about him. And like the blade of a knife. Why would you give him so many details?
And why did you just describe him down to the bottoms?
I never thought you'd have to introduce him to my father. So I just kinda made it up as I went. Start the same. I have to see if this boyfriend is worth marrying you. So here I am, and I've got a big problem.
Okay, I get the picture now. I fit the bill, so you want me to act like I'm your man in front of you.
Well, you catch on fast. That's pretty much it. If that finds out I don't really have a boyfriend, you force me into an arranged marriage with some strange man I don't even know. Please, nobody else looks anything like you. Could you give me a boyfriend for just a little while?
Fine. That you're saying a bit of a part. But when I marry some guy they don't even know, that end up spending the rest of their life with him.
Fine.
You bind yourself into this corner, while I feel your pain. I'll pretend to be in the front.
Yes, I'm so glad I didn't do so. My name's Coco. Please call me Coco-chan. Oh, and sorry, didn't catch your name.
I'm Goro Majima.
I see. Majima-san. I'm going to address you as Goro-chan.
Goro-chan? Just so much that. That's taking things a little faster, I think.
Oh no, anyways, just pretend, but we're in a romantic relationship. We can't be so formal with each other. We have to make this Felipe work. Yes, I do. Well, let's not waste any more time. Where should we be going?
Like, right now. Right now? I'm getting exhausted.
Was this about going
where?
I don't know, I better keep up. We're going to the restaurant where we'll meet with my dad over dinner. Three of us.
We're gonna meet him over dinner? I've got nothing to say to you, that Coco-chan. Shake hands and then matcha and bang.
No, that won't work at all. That won't be reassured unless I show him what kind of mom I would from this. We have to go now, Goro-chan. I don't know.
I don't know what I was expecting, but you will. Get pissed off easily.
Oh no, he's just stubborn. He's not scary though. He seems to think I'm not the sharpest tool in the shed, and he basically beats me more than he should, but in the meantime, he's as good a father as I could as well.
Well, I suppose it's still tough to bring the guy. If I had a daughter like you, I'd be pretty worried.
You see, so if you start saying a bunch of weird stuff, he'll blow his lid on you and like,
forget this guy, I'll arrange you next time.
Sorry, then.
No problem.
So, let's go over my boyfriend's backstory now.
Excuse me, I need a backstory.
We've been going out for 6 months. We're at this place going at Andres and watching movies. Your favorite food is the way I try something, okay?
What was all that now?
I had to leave. I got some videos about my girlfriend, so I might stuff up. If he gets curious, can you make sure you've got it memorized?
Well, you ain't exactly making this a walk in the park. How am I supposed to remember what is the case?
Fine, count it up.
If we've been going out for 6 months, we're at an
Oh, hey, new follower. Hello.
So, going out for 6 months, then this, she like going out on drives and watching movies. And I'm in class. Okay. Are you with my best shot?
There he is. Over here.
Hmm.
Chan, this is my father.
Hello, I'm Coco's father. Please to meet.
This is the man I'm seeing, Goro Majima.
You know, what I think of it, meeting a girl's dad for the first time is super important for an animal. It's good and don't make me important the rest of my life.
Sorry, I guess I better buckle down and get into this role properly.
A different antagonist, right?
First impressions, Steve. That's all you know.
What? Tempting, but no.
Just a
moment. I understand my daughter looks to you for a lot of support.
Support?
Oh no, in fact it's quite crazy. Kokoasana stood by me at every time. Well, how gorgeous of you. Something that gets to me this time is the erosion of courtesy in today's youth. So many can't even manage a proper introduction, just indifferently.
That's right, eh? Goro-chan sound like those stereotypical men.
First impression went well. Playing the respect of that was a pretty slow.
Eika, Makun,
I was saying surprised you really do exist.
I beg your pardon.
Well, my dad are the describe you as a man who is tall yet slender waist. Sports an eye patch, a strong hair type like an initiative Gabriel Newton like a language such. I never imagined such a man could actually exist, yet here you are in the flesh.
See, then,
I told you I wasn't dying. My boyfriend's right here in front of you. Yes, I figured he was another fragment of your overactive imagination, so I'm really quite shocked.
Huh?
Active imagination, but I don't make these things up that often, do I?
You'll take this into the end good terms, and here that's a decent guy, too.
Stern, what is it?
Oh yes, Majima. Look, I may have mentioned it already, but what line of work are you in again?
Yet I would be a bit.
I'm an artist.
Oh, yes, that's right. I hear you're an artist.
I never would have guessed from your appearance. And if I said it's came from a dentist at all, to be frank.
I get to talk a lot, and yes.
Oh, that. You've been so rude to me, Goro-chan.
Here. I'm just glad I remember what Goro-chan told me. That hack you of a monster.
Incidentally, Majima-kun.
Yes.
I was wondering, how did you come to meet your Goro-chan? Well, that's...
I didn't ask you, I asked Majima.
Well, tell me, Majima-kun, how did you two get to know each other?
He's trying to see how it is.
Goro-chan doesn't have his supposedly meet Goro-chan in a way that won't make him more suspicious.
Lisa met Sue's children at a movie because he liked movies. We happened to sit next to each other at a movie theater. That's how we met.
The movie? Come to think of it, Coco, I did mention that you enjoy movies.
Yes, like I said, Coco-chan just happened to sit next to me. The flick was a real tearjerker, so I offered her my handkerchief, and the rest is history.
Yes, that's how it went. Amazing, Goro-chan. I can't believe you came up with such... I mean, remember it like it was 15 minutes ago. It was so romantic.
Well, what a for teacher's meeting, then.
I'm just glad she didn't meet her boyfriend in any place she should. Of course not. My Goro-chan is a proper and decent...
Woven Coco-chan swag story and came up with a data brings to end.
Majima-kun, I'm going to put it to you straight. What is it about my daughter that you found attractive? Dad? Why did you put him on the spot like that?
I'm sorry, Coco,
but I'm just so worried about you. You're still so innocent like a chatty. Is me awake and not worrying about whether or not you even managed to lead a proper and prosperous family life? If there's a man who would love you and treat you well, why, I would give you my blessing for a marriage right this instant. That's why I need to ask Majima-kun. What about Kokua? Did you find that like?
He's looking at me so here.
Yes, I can blame him. He's not a shit person. I don't like drinking him, but I talk to Kuchan and Kuchan. But I find a good reason why I can't have it.
Yeah, that's the one.
I fell in love with how great the Omine Dryer seemingly says. Oh, I must agree with you then. Your Omine Dryer has a special quality to it. I love it too. But Majima, if that's all you say, my daughter, I don't want to give her away to you. If it's delicious Omine Dryer that you want, you could just eat it. You could just ask it from a record. I don't need to have a chance to ask the real life for you. From her husband, if you want the guy who appreciates his own wonderful.
Huh?
Oh, look at you, excuse me. I need to go wash up. Oh, sure, honey. I'm fine. What is it? Her bothering her nose is not down to just in her room. Thank you for playing along with my daughter's life. I love it. Yeah, it's up. Give me all alone, huh? Just to be safe. Of course. I could see through you two from the moment I sat down. Was it that obvious? If you knew from the start, why gave us a win? I could tell this by the way my daughter was talking then. It wasn't her father for all this year for nothing. Why'd you go along with this dumb chariot for so long? Kokua was so desperate to convince me. It's my fault she tried a stone like this, isn't it? I'm sure it's because I kept pushing her into this with all those suitors I'd arranged for her. You know, you're the other way. You somehow got through her. I lost my wife when Kokua was still an infant. I raised her alone without anyone's help. I tried to raise her well so no one would look down on her for not having a mother. But you know, I've been overly protective of her. I can see now that she's capable of standing on her own 2 feet. I've got to stop telling my daughter to do this or that. No more pushing her to meet potential suitors. She's her own woman. It's time I learned to let go. But the truth is, there's another reason I want her with a little cherry. Someday my daughter's going to bring a real boyfriend to me. And I thought this might be good practice. As to you, I got a good idea of what to expect. And comes, I think I manage. Nah, it still ain't a good feeling to spend so much time lying to someone who knew from the start. But I gotta tell you, I think avoiding an arranged marriage wasn't the only reason Kokuchan was distant. What do you mean? She was trying to show you that you don't need to worry about her so much.
Worry?
Yeah, pretty plain to see that. She's the source of wonder of your worries. I think she wanted to reassure you that she's capable of looking after herself. She wanted to prove to you she can manage her own affairs. I get the map.
Sorry, I'm back. I hope that wasn't too awkward for you guys. Did you even break the silence?
Welcome back, Okochan. So listen, your dad actually knew...
Majima-kun?
Yes.
Kokua, you have done well finding this man. I had nothing to worry about after all. You know, right? What a chance a super guy. So this means you'll stop trying to set me up, right? Yes. I can see there's no longer any need. Really? Awesome. It's been an awfully long day. I'm heading back to my hotel. Oh, okay. Like, walk you back, huh?
So can we finally get to getting some rest?
Kuro-chan, thank you so much for being my boyfriend. We're in just a few minutes today. Kuro-chan, I think you did an excellent job pretending to be my boyfriend.
Glad to hear it.
I wanted to give you this. Thank you. Whatever the case, I think I'm free from that handing me to meet his suitors. What a relief.
That's good.
Yes, well, I have to wear my hat to this time.
Yep.
When you get that real boyfriend, you better do a proper introduction so he doesn't have to worry about it. I'll try. Bye now.
Oh, well, I forgot something. Give me just a moment. Something wrong? Ayame-kun,
there's one last thing I need to say.
What's that?
Ayame-kun, I'm glad I got to talk to you. You went through all the weather for pretending to be my daughter's boyfriend just for my sake. You're a good man.
I was trying to put one past you and give me too much credit, man.
No, no, not at all, that's fine. I'd like it if you would be my daughter's real boyfriend.
Well, yes, you see.
Say, can you please ask my daughter for a girl? Consider it for a moment, please. Haven't the fresh enemies you think that's a good idea? Because you're the ideal man. I think I can safely introduce a fisher to you.
Oh, slow down. I'm having trouble with the powers.
You could start by just pretending, that's fine. Like, if she won't take you, I will.
You just say what I think you'll be.
Yeah, Dad, what's all this about? Give me a little. This is why I'm single.
He just went right back around to trying to find suitors. Yeah. I'll get that later. Now time to finally actually go home.